into this in just a minute. I'm gonna disappear for a sec. Souls-style game that I was messing with earlier today on YouTube. Get everything open. Because for some reason, if OBS is told to capture the Godot window when you run the game, it doesn't capture it and it just white screens the game. So instead, what I have to do is display the entire screen. So I prefer to get everything up and ready for that. Okay. Think I'm pretty much there. Okay. Get a display capture. Wait. There we go. Okay. I have opened up Godot, but I don't know how much programming I'm going to be doing tonight. We might do a bit. I'm focusing more on design at the moment. So these are the ones that I did earlier on. Okay, so these are the ones that I did earlier on, and yeah, so we've got this guy. I think I'm going to call him the Tormented. Let me just put the background on. So he's got no arms and he's got these spears lodged through him. There's this guy, which is like a mage cultist sort of guy. This is like a metallic helmet, kind of like Pyramid Head, but like a bit more narrow and pointed. Just turn the green on. So this is a sword. I was going for something like the Moonlight Sword, so in the actual engine when this is rendered, it would have that over it and then particle effects and things all flying off it and it would be animated and things like that. These are just rough designs for the minute. So I'm gonna have a quick browse through Pinterest and see if anything inspires us, and then yeah, we'll start designing some creatures, some characters, see where we get to. That's an interesting I like this guy with all the swords stuck in his back. It's an interesting design when the sword is like squared off on the end. I tend to always point the swords, not always necessary. I like all the damage on this guy as well, that's pretty cool. So, I could probably, I'd like to do something like that, I think that could be cool. So we'll keep him in mind. That one's pretty cool. He's a bit generic. Oh, I like that one. Got these really narrow legs and claws. Some kind of wraith sort of thing could be cool. Like in some tattered robe thing. Not that well. I'm not a fan of the tentacle things at the bottom, I don't think they have a lot. To be fair, I dismissed this just when I first saw it, but now the idea of like this monster that's like kind of childlike. It's kind of cool. Like it's dressed itself up in armor and it believes that it's, you know, like a warrior or something. Yeah, that could be cool. Keep. I like that. Interesting style. Yeah, some kind of like arachnid with like an exoskeleton humanoid sort of thing going on could be interesting. Yeah, I think we'll go for this big dude. The board. So I've got all of these. I do quite like this guy. Not sure what to change about him. Maybe you could have the same headgear as the cultist, like you could be a variation on the cultist, maybe. Maybe instead of this big sword, they've like replaced his arms with blades or something. Maybe it's like, maybe he's got like some kind of gauntlets on that just like round off his hands. Like a big metal boxing glove. I don't know, on second thoughts, maybe this guy's a little too generic, but I mean, every enemy doesn't have to be like
completely unique. Maybe he doesn't have legs. What you could do if you didn't have legs. See, I was thinking like, this would be easier if I. I'm just going to plug the drawing tablet in, and then I'll pop back on. Not sure how well this is going to work because I haven't used this in ages. Okay, it's got pressure sensitivity down, that's good. In this one, So he's got like, what the hell is this thing? Right, he's got this fairly large torso, these giant shoulder pieces like here. But we could sort of like fuck him up a bit around the midsection here. So he's just ripped in half. And then as one of them like pyramid things like the other guy. Like one of them big metallic helmets. And then, why does this keep freezing? And then got like his big hand. And he like walks around on his hands. Wow, that is a terrible hand, right? Ignore the terrible drawing for now. But now I need to think of something that I can put around this area instead of legs, because he can't use his hands for weapons or anything most of the time because he'll be walking on them. So maybe like an intestine whip or something. That could be kind of fucked up. So he's got the intestines, they're all knotted around each other and shit. But to be fair, I don't know if that would work. Plus, that would be quite hard to make, I think. Maybe we could do it so he doesn't actually use this area as a weapon. Instead, he still has his sword, which he sort of uses as a walking stick. So, like, you've got his body and his shoulder leaning up onto it. I really wish this would stop freezing. I'm not sure why it does. Alright. Sword handles there, his hand wrapped around it. He's got his other arm supporting him. Big helmet then. And then he's fucked up from the body down. Leaving like a big nasty ass trail. Now this I think I could make. Oh, I've just accidentally made something kind of cool. Actually, no, I don't like it. So, I was gonna do it so that he's holding the blade, but that makes no sense because his hand'd be falling off. He's like dragging himself along with this giant blade. So he's gonna be like a pogo stick sort of enemy. But obviously his arms need to be fucking huge as fuck to support the idea that he can throw himself around on a sword. Really over the top metallic helmet as well. Yeah. I emphasize the arms a lot in this design. It's gonna have like really big fuck off muscles. And then, do we still want all the spears and things in him? There's not these swords and things all sticking out. It's hard to tell from this drawing because it's. We'll see how it looks in pixel art. For now, I can ditch that. Let's go back into so we want to have. He's going to be a pretty fucking big dude. So if we take our regular human character, no particular reason, I just want to design this character from the start. Right, so yeah, I think that's a good size because the cultists are a little taller and lankier than the player character, the standard human. And this guy's going to be like a huge behemoth. He is going to lose his legs. That's okay because we can bulk his arms. But then he needs to be bigger because otherwise, then he's essentially just going to be the same height as. The cultists, which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but at the same time, I want a bit more fun. So he's going to be quite big, and then we're going to sever that middle. To be fair, because he's big as well, it allows us to put a little more refinement into the details of him, which is nice. So we can quite easily bulk up the muscles and things. Need refining. muscles as well. The head is going to be just the larger version of that, so I can probably use this as a guide. Yeah, so we'll just put it on the level, I think. So the neck is going to be coming out like that. So his neck muscles are like that. Yeah, that looks better. And this is going to be all like tight and mangled. This arm is shit. I don't like this arm. Let's get rid of it. I think that needs to be a bit more thumb-like. Yeah, that's better. Okay. And these muscles are all fucked as well. I'm going to cut that in slightly a little bit more, so yeah, it'll come together a lot more once it has shading and things as well, colours and that. So if his joint is like there, that one, a bit about that. So what do you want to that might work. That comes out way too far. There's going to have to be quite a bit of perspective on this guy because of how large he is. So his hands and it comes to about here. And then this to look right. Okay, it'll come together with shaking and things like that, so let's that's not so bad. Good. Yeah, I'm gonna draw what this gets the chip hanging out of me. Gripping on to that sword. Annoying now because I've got to redraw this arm and I was quite happy with this arm. It's fine. Just in case I fuck this up and I don't like it. Alright, so his shoulder is gonna come doing that. This is gonna it'll be like that. These guys' arms are fucking huge. And then the hand, I don't think I'll be able to rotate this. Closer than I thought. Something to that degree. Might be able to just clean this up. That's not bad. No, that doesn't look right at all now. That needs to be a more angle to everything, I think. So his arm's gonna come around. No, it's like a leg though. Right, let's just fucking delete that. So comes up. How's this gonna look? I think it needs to come up even more than that. It needs to be like really twisting his back, I think, for this pose. So like the center of mass is gonna be, I don't know, center of mass, his center line is like here. Let me get a new plan. So we've got, he's facing like that way, and then his neck, the center of his neck's like there, center of his body's there, shoulders are like that. Let's get a different color. This will help me with the pose. So shoulders are across. Then we've got joints here. That arm is just completely incorrect. It's not going to be that extreme, I don't think. So then, that then It almost feels like it's backwards. Like this should be the one with the short. Okay, let's flip him again. We'll do him in the opposite direction. Oops. So now. This is shit. So, get rid of that. So, his arms. Arms coming around. No. His arms going up. And then it's going out further. That's where his hand is. And this arm is coming out like that. And then it's going to depend how big the sword is. So if we do the sword like that, then his arm is going to come down to like that. With hand balance like that. His torso is going to have to be extended quite a bit, so his muscles will come out like that. Get some like rib cage and stuff showing in there, that could be interesting. Yeah. This is on course to be one of my favourite designs. This is really cool. So, let's try and follow that guide a little bit. So, bring. Right, so then with this extension up, his shoulder's going to come out like that. That's that muscle there. No. That muscle would be like that. Then you have that there. So the chest would come out like that. And then, okay, it's too exaggerated, so it'd come up like that. You have the bicep, the, I can't remember what the one on the back's called, it's that one. And then you've got your forearm muscles, which, if he's come around that way, they're going to be on the back. So you have like that one, and then this one. I don't like this perfectly straight one. That looks okay. So his hand's gonna be twisted with it, unless it's upside down. Which means his elbow is like here. That's okay. And then so his hand's up for that. That means that it can come up a little more. Push that line back a little. Okay. And then his thumb's going to be like there. His hand's wrap around like that. That's just placeholder for his hand for now. Let's try and get the other arm in as well. So, chest, come out like that. you've got shoulder. And then Oyster and on the back. Elbow there. And then right down the left. You've got the forearm muscles. And then let's just do a placeholder hand. Okay, let's see without the guide. Yeah, I think I like this a lot more. I'm gonna drop that. Yeah, that looks good. That looks way better than muscles to lay this shit. Okay. So, not sure exactly how this guy is going to work in the game. So when he's walking, I guess this is just a stance for now, just to get the design. It doesn't need to be implemented in game style. So yeah, I mean this could be like ready in position, I guess. So the sword's gonna have the hilt around. I do quite like that big chunky squared off sword. Something like that. And it's got its serrated edges on either side. Actually, it could have like teeth on one side and then like a bladed edge on the other. I like that. I could make a brush to do this, but for the sake of using it once, I don't really want to. Plus, this isn't that slow, so it's not really a big deal. Okay. Yeah, something like that. So this one's going to be an absolute prick to animate and things. To be fair, though, most of the animation can be done in Engine, so it's not too bad. Right, how many tiles is that? Fuck, it's taking up a lot. That's okay, so we can get him unleashed. Maybe shorten the sword a little. There we go. Works okay. So yeah, the idea is that he would essentially like lunge himself around, so he'd stab the sword into the ground and like launch himself up in the air, which would be cool as well because you could have like loads of slamming attacks on the player. So that could be interesting. So I'm guessing this is like a boss character in my head, really. Let's get rid of the guides for now. I'll have a cool looking handle on it. Actually, I won't do a big handle because it'll make it take up more tiles and I don't really want to. Actually, fuck it. Who cares? Right. Interesting looking at that. We do breaks in this pattern. That could make for a more interesting looking design as well. Apologies if you can hear background noise like a dog barking. Oh, that's gone different here. Okay, that's right. I could have deleted one too many. Right, I like that. That's pretty cool. And I'll, in fact, I'm gonna remove this line and then I'll add like a. Something like that down that edge. I don't look how thin his wrists would be. That looks weird. Oh, this looks fucked. Be able to stop staring at this damn wrist now. This wrist's gonna piss me off. My god, why is your wrist so fucked? It's like he's got a tumor growing out the top of the fucking thing. What's going on? Damn. Hefty fucking wrist, boy. Okay, that I'm a little more happy with. Alright. This is going to be a bastard to animate. Might look cool. Okay, now I'm going to iterate him to sort of store that. Let's color him. Don't know if I want to go as pale as the tormented guys. Maybe like their shade color. Even that might be a bit too pale, to be honest. No, it's too dark. We'll see where we get with this. So, I'm just going to start by outlining the muscles and things just to make sure we don't lose any form. I don't want to lose the form. Alright. Get back one as well. I want to select this from this back. Let's fill in some gaps. Let's do that to show where his fingers and things lie. Goals on there. I wanna outline his chest. There is the center of his chest. And I'm just going to cough around there. Okay. I think we can do. It's getting there. chest looks okay. Let's see the shoulder. I think it's further back. I'll probably have to look up some anatomy pictures before I finalise this, to be honest, because this is very anatomy heavy. I'm not good at anatomy. Alright, so I'm going to actually leave this as like a skin colour and then add more on to it. I kind of want to give him like a bit of a rib, like a busted out rib cage. Bunch of guts and shit all hanging down. There is a library for Godot that does physics-based ropes, and I'm thinking maybe I had a couple of intestines hanging down that are like swinging around like physics-based intestines. That could be interesting. This guy is going to be an absolute fucking pain in the arse to animate. I'm going to have to like separate each like muscle group, I think. Which is fine. It'll take a lot of time, but it should look cool. Right, I'm going to iterate again. Am I going to fit there? No. Okay, we'll go... actually, I can just... Why the fuck is that? Weird old papers too. Okay. I want to draw in a rib cage. So I'll do it in white to begin with. So I'm going to bring my guide back. So centers there, means his ribs are going to hook around. So if he centers there, his spine is going to be like that. Let's change the colour. So you've got his spine and down the back there, center coming up the front. That center line's a bit off. Center like that. Yeah. So that's in line. I think I need to tuck that bit back a bit there. Yeah, back there. I'll work on that in a second. So that looks like that. And then you have his ribs that will follow these circles. Like that. So we can get maybe two on each side and a bit of the spinal cord and some goop all over them. I think we can probably get away with that. I that's the last energy drink for now, so it's water for me. Okay. Let's do it in white to begin with. So there's going to be a rib there. Comes around like that, and then his spine is coming down like that, and then out. His spine's going to be quite thick. Yeah, that looks good. And then that's going to be his top rib. This is all a bit off. Yeah, I feel a bit better about that. Yeah, and then some bits coming off that. No, I need to. So that will be in shadow, and that most of the spine is going to be shadowed, I think. But we can highlight discs like that, and then comes out, that should be hooked around, making those bits shadowed. That'll be shadowed, that bit's sticking out. This is shadowed. Yeah. I think that's right. A little better with some strawberry jam on it, I think. Let's connect the bits of flesh. Bits over. Not a fan of that. And then I was going to refine this bit, wasn't I? Yeah, that looks good. This hand needs work. So, I kind of want these fingers to spread on. So that's like one finger. He's got like, I think I designed him with like three fingers, like two fingers and a thumb in mind. So if we do like two stubs like that, and then down like that. too bad. I've definitely drawn worse. Right. It's getting there, definitely getting there. I'm quite happy with it so far. We can refit him back into at least he's within the tiles. Right, let's iterate again. I know I can do layers and things, but I like to be able to see like immediately like where it, so like we started up here, moved on to this and then, you know, rather than constantly toggling on and off layers and things like that. Layers are good for like opacity and things, like how I do like the guidelines and that, they're quite good for that. Or like when you're actually like animating and things like that and building it up. Right now I'm just designing, so we don't need to worry too much about things like that. I'm going to alter his helmet as well. But I'm going to do some of his strawberry jam first, I think. Lay down a base red to begin with. And that's gonna be all around. And then probably give most of the white a douse in as well. Because if these bones have been in someone who's just been cut in half, they're probably not going to be pure white, I can't imagine. And now, let's deepen it a little. I want to do some muscle highlights as well to really get like the form of his muscles. Sort of round them out. Try not to make him look oily though. Not that type of game. Oh man, he needs nipples. We didn't give the man nipples. How is it I almost made a walking torso without nipples? Blasphemy. It's gonna be hard to even tell what that is. Okay, maybe you won't have nipples. Well, I mean, big. No. Need to behave, right? Okay. Right. Oh, we need some highlights on this hand as well. Go across the knuckle of the thumb. See, my head's telling me that that bit should be in shade, but I don't like the way that looks. Maybe not. Part of it, no. That looks weird to me now. I think it might be this like line here that's doing it. I had this problem up here, didn't I? Muscles backwards. The bigger one is underneath it. Or is it no? I think that bit goes on. I'm not happy with that. It's okay. I think that's okay. That's passable, I think. Right. So I would like now to, I mean, he's got to have some guts hanging out there. Need to finish the sword. His helmet needs doing. Alright, I'm gonna move the iterations around. Which confused me. He needs to go up there. And then actually this one needs to come up. And then this one. And now we can iterate again. This time we're going for metallics. So the sword and the helmet. Quickly throw it on some bases. Right, I think the handle, the hilt's disgusting. That just looks fucking stupid. I think the handle should be like strapped. So I'm thinking like that sort of colour, but then with like deep purple sort of strapping to it. Oh, I like straps. That looks more like a stone sort of texture now. Need a way to make it look threaded, maybe with a bit more texture work. Patching a bit of that. Nope, still looks like stone. I mean, it's not bad looking. It's just not really the effect I was going for. Maybe if when it came up at the top there, that doesn't make any physical sense with the harmony. So it's. Oh, that's going to be horrible to animate. Right. I'll come back to the handle. Let's work on the blade. Actually, now let's go up onto the hilt. Let's use this purple again. Actually, that might reinforce that it's the same material when I don't want it to be. Rubbish. What did it look like on? Oh, I like the bolts. That's pretty cool. So it's like pretty much like a straight bar. But then. Has these bolts dotted through. That does not look like the effect I was going for. I think I'm overusing purple, which was not the intent. Oh, I'm pressing every button. No. No, it's not doing it. Okay. Let's completely remove the hilt altogether. It'd be easier if I was working with it straight, actually, wouldn't it? So, like, we bring it out like that. Yeah, I think that's okay. And then those bits like that. And go across. Yeah, okay, that looks way better. Now we have the problem with the outline. Have I outlined the other characters? No. Okay. So we don't need to worry about having a black outline. Good, good, good. In that case, then I'm going to get rid of any black by. I'm going to. We just want to do it in this area. There we go. So now there's not more black. Now we can go. Almost black and set this in a little. Oh, quite like that as well. We could kind of play it off that these are bolts all along here as well. They'd probably be lighter though, wouldn't they? Like that. Because they're catching the light as they stick out. I'm not going to have them this light though, because I want the edge to be like glistening like a polished edge. In fact, we can probably make the edge slightly more. Polished. Probably like right the way across actually. In fact, I'm gonna show a bevel. That. Don't know if I like that. Oh. We can dither it, that looks cool. Probably just if I'm getting really close to the camera, I'm not trying to concentrate and all. It's just taking all of my brain power. There's not a lot to go around. Alright, okay. These should be catching the light pretty good as well, so let's highlight them. Yeah, something like that. We get a preview on that. Yeah, that looks pretty sick. I'm quite happy with that. I don't like the handle. The handle's getting on my nerves now. It's redesign the handles, chop them, but I quite liked it with all the holes and things in. I like the holes a little bigger. And then extend these sorts a bit. I'll make the holes bigger even still. And then I'm gonna quite heavily darken. Maybe even more so. I don't want to get too many shades in this because it'll start looking less like pixel art. I quite like the way that it has that pixely look. Not happy with the blade yet. The blade looks too flat. Yeah, I'm gonna shade in under each one of these bolts. Let's come back to the sword, work on the helmet for now. I want to make it sharper. So it comes down a little bit. Let's catch the light. Like that. Right, we can do that with the sword as well. Sorts of like glaring, glaring light fractures on it. If that's the right terminology. Well, I've ruined the edge on it. I mean, in-game effects will also do a lot for this, but if we make a new layer, let's try screen. It's looking less like pixel art now. Let's get rid of that. I think that looks okay for now. I'm probably going to change that though, I think. I'm more into adding effects in game for stuff like that rather than in the actual sprite itself. We'll see. See where we go. What the fuck am I doing now? I'm on that page, like, that's what it's like. Quite a large section. Do I want it that large? Maybe like that. Yeah, I like that. I think the reason pixel art's so good for things like this is because it almost feels like you're carving the lighting effects and things into the character. At least for me anyway. That's how I imagine it. Like I'm sort of pushing it all around. It's quite different to other types of drawing. Now it looks like a big point. I think this. That needs to come down a little. We're getting right on the verge of pyramid head here. Especially with the big sword. That just kind of looks. Yeah. It looks too round. Need to straighten out these lines. Alright, I'm gonna restart the light down this middle bit. Yeah, that's fine. Clean slate now. Don't need that colour. Right. So it's down and then down. That's the centre line. Right. Which means all of this side can be quite heavily shaded. And along this line can be even more heavily shaded. So that's the immediate drop off point, meaning there's less light getting to that. It still looks rounded, it's this part here, I think. Right, we need to. This needs to come. Like a straight crawl. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, that's way better. Okay. And then actually you wouldn't. No. Okay. And then just hang it around. We can add some scratches and things with this colour as well, so damaging a bit. That looks really good. Quite happy with that. What does it look like if we dither that edge in? Don't know how I overuse dithering. Okay. Right. This is, it's getting there. I'm getting to a point where I'm happier with it. Yeah. I'm definitely getting happier with it. To be honest, I'm starting to think that handle might be a bit too long. It's sort of overshadowing the length of the blade. Like, the blade's meant to be big, but the blade actually looks kind of short. But I don't want to move all of his arm around again, to be honest. And I think the blade's probably long enough. So if we chop this down a little, something like that. Yeah, this is getting much better. I want to add some more contrast to this. Go along. I want to paint it a little more. I don't know. Yeah, I think that's fine. And then bring that over along like that. Yeah. Yeah, that looks good. I think for his size, this is an appropriate amount of detail. Like this guy has a decent amount of detail, especially like the little staff and everything. But the smaller you go, the less detail you can fit. And I think this might have a bit too much packed in. I didn't do the spears and things sticking in, did I? I might do like an alternate version with that. Because I think it could look interesting. I also want to do guts and shit. I think once I've finished with this character, I'm going to call it quits for the night. We'll see where we go. If I merge this down, is it gonna... Okay, no, it doesn't fuck the... It doesn't fuck the... effect on the layer. Quite good. Right. Yeah, so... how does intestines look? They're sort of... pulled up on the floor, I guess. It's like a big pile of guts. And
attached into it. Why would I want it coming out like that? Doesn't make any sense. Going straight down. Something like that. That can be one that's like rolled over. That doesn't make any sense either. Whoa. What do I do there? Oh, Blur. Yeah, it was Blur. That actually makes like an interesting effect. That's cool. Not what I'm going for though. So, there we go. Right. Let's add some more drips and things. Need this to look really like jellified because I don't want it to look like he's holding himself up with his guts. I'm going to do this quite ropey looking if I can. And then I'm going to make it all like glistening and gross. That's quite good. Maybe add a couple of stringy things sticking off. Anything that just looks gross. I'm not terribly worried about being anatomically correct. Because let's be honest, if you've been cut in half like this, like you did, and that's like vital organs are gone, like losing a ridiculous amount of blood, you're dead at this point. But this isn't real life, so. Although it's like we've based the anatomy and things on real life ish. We're not terribly concerned with emulating real life. I'll go all white and then it's where I want it to glisten. And then see what we've got. Multiply does fuck all. That shit for the wrong reasons. All the violence. These are cool. Okay. Oh, shit, I keep doing the Photoshop. Then the controller merged it. Okay. I mean, that looks pretty good as it is. I'm quite happy with that. Need some darker red though. The shading. To his skin down still. Wanna make sure like it looks like he's been ripped in half. Yeah, this is looking really cool. Right, let's go for some final highlights, I think. So, get more of a highlight than the... Definitely want to get something like that. Right. Let's try some other ones.
Okay. I'm quite happy with that. Is there anything else I want to do with him? I'm quite happy with that, to be honest. That's alright. The anatomy's not great. But I suppose when I start chopping it all into pieces and getting different like rotations and positions of each part and all that sort of thing, I can improve it then. It's senseless keep working on this now because this is just a design. Yeah. Alright. Well, on that note, I think I'm gonna leave it there. I'm definitely not just googling a thanks for watching thing. Oh man, they're all terrible. Ah, fuck it. Let's go for this one. We'll grab. Yes. You couldn't tell what I'm doing. Alright, well, thanks for anyone who's been watching, or anyone who will watch this after the fact. It's been quite fun. We drew something pretty cool, I think. I'm quite happy with that. It's pretty good. So hopefully someday we'll make a game out of this thing. But yeah, that's it from me. See ya.